I want to add in a new user to our MySQL database. So I'm going to open up our MySQL Command Line Client, type in our password, secret one, and I'm going to paste in the line, grant select on ODB84 MySQL DB TBL EMP to Joe at localhost identified by Joe's pass. What this means is the password is going to be Joe's pass, J-O-E-S-P-A-S-S. This will be for a new account, Joe, J-O-E, for localhost. And Joe can only select on ODB84 MySQL DB the table EMP. He won't be able to see the phone number table. Let's hit enter, and that's done. There are other ways to grant access depending on what you're going to do, and lots of information online to follow up on it. But basically, all you need to do is type it in right there at the command line. I'm going to close this and open up the ODB84 MySQL DB for the JDBC connection that we created in the last video. And I'm going to open up a table for this. Instead of signing in as root, I'm going to sign in as Joe, using Joe's pass as a password. And we see that Joe can see the ODB84 MySQL DB and the employee table, but not the phone number table. If he tries to update something on this table, he gets an error. Update command denied for Joe. If you logged in directly, you're going to see another database here called test. And I'm going to close this. Now I'm going to go in through MySQL Workbench and add a user using MySQL Workbench. I'm going to click on this local instance, MySQL 56, type in my root password, secret one. Now I'm on the management tab, and I'm going over to users and privileges. Here we see Joe, who we just created. And I want to add a new account. I'm going to add in Cindy, C-I-N-D-Y. We will give her the password, C-I-N-D-Y-S-P-A-S-S. And confirm that, C-I-N-D-Y-P-A-S-S. And under the account limits, we can set those if we like. We can give her administrative roles if we like. I am going to stick to the basic schema privileges. I'm going to add an entry. Here we can give her access to anything, the percent sign. We can limit it to different things, and we'll do that in a minute. Let's go down to selected schema. We can give her only access to a specific schema. I'm going to give her access to anything that starts with ODB. So ODB percent sign, clicking OK. And then I need to give her what she can do in there. I can say she can only select or she can insert. I am going to select all. So Cindy can do anything for a database that starts out with ODB. Let's apply this. And it's telling me I typed in the wrong passwords. So coming back over to login, Cindy's pass, apply. There we go. Let's create one more user. This will be for John, J-O-H-N, J-O-H-N-S-P-A-S-S, John's pass, J-O-H-N-S-P-A-S-S. And we're going right over to the schema privileges. He can have access down here under selected schema, ODB 84. Okay. And he can select. That's it. Apply. And I mentioned earlier that if you logged in directly, you would also have seen things that start with test. If we click under this anonymous, it's got a test database here. Anything that starts with test will show up if you log in directly. If you don't want to see that, you can delete this anonymous user. Let's minimize this and go into the ODB84. And prove everything works here. I'm going to go into the forms. It's asking me to sign in. I will sign in as Cindy. Cindy's pass. Click OK. And we see under the phone number that we are missing a dash for this second phone number, 555-1234. Let's save that. Going to the next user and back, making sure it got saved. That's updated properly. I'm going to close out and open again. Go to the forms, open. This time I'll sign in as John, J-O-H-N-S-P-A-S-S. John can view everything. But if I try and update something, 555-1234, and I get an error, insert command denied for John. So we saw two ways to insert a new MySQL user. One way was with the MySQL command line client, and the other was with the MySQL workbench. We'll notice that on the MySQL workbench, we weren't able to get down to that table level like we were with the MySQL command line client. And I only went into one brief example using the command line client, but there's lots of information online on how to insert them. Now that you know where to type in that information, it's up to you to decide which way you want to use.